Hi friends, I am Madhu. This is part 2 of the video Mathematic Formulas. I have made part 1 as well, and if you have not watched the part 1, I have given the link in the description. So before we start with the topic Mathematic Formulas, we will begin with an inspiring thought. So the thought for this video is, education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change this world. This thought is said by Nelson Mandela, first non-apartheid president of South Africa. As the black people, the people whose skin color is black, are very discriminated in many parts of the world. So he fought against this discrimination. He just fought that they should be equally treated as other people are. So, and that's why he is known as first non-apartheid president of South Africa. So in this thought, it is said that education is the most powerful weapon. Yeah, this thought is very relevant. It is true that education is the key for improving your life, for improving others' life. It is the tool for changing this world. Education is the key for eliminating all the problems like poverty, racial discrimination, gender inequality. All these social problems are eliminated by education. And education improves the quality of your life. It just helps you know your skills and it develops your personality. So education is the tool for changing this world. And you can say most powerful weapon you can use to change this world. So it is a very famous thought said by Nelson Mandela. Now let's quickly get started with our topic, that is Mathematic Formulas. So the first chapter from which we will take the formulas is Profit Loss and Discount Tax. So in this chapter we see many formulas. Some of them are, if we have to calculate profit, the formula is selling price minus cost price. See, if I have bought any object and I have sold it, obviously I will have a profit or a loss. Agar maine koi bhi cheez khareed ke dobara sell ki hai, to mere paas ya to profit hoga ya fir loss. So if we have to calculate the profit, the formula is selling price minus cost price. For example, I bought a pen for 20 rupees and I sold it in 25 rupees, then obviously my cost price is less and my selling price is more. So I am having a profit, and profit can be calculated by selling price minus cost price, because obviously if you are having profit, selling price will be more. And if we have to calculate the loss, then it will be opposite, cost price minus selling price. If I have bought any object in more price and I have sold it in less amount, then obviously I am having a loss. So for calculating the loss, it is cost price minus selling price. Now next one is profit percent. If I am having a profit and I have to calculate that what is the percentage of that profit, then the formula is profit by a cost price into 100, because we are calculating the percentage. That's why we'll be multiplied by 100. Profit will be divided by cost price and it will be divided by 100, multiplied by 100, and then we will get the profit percent. Same for loss percent, just here loss will come, loss divided by cost price into 100, that will be the loss percent. So these are very important formulas for profit and loss. So friends, here are some more formulas related to this chapter. In this chapter we do many questions, but some questions are related that we have to find the selling price and the cost price, gain or loss percent is given. We have to find the cost price, then selling price or gain or loss percent is given. So sometime selling price is given, sometime cost price is given. So when we have to find the selling price, when cost price and gain or loss percent is given, what we have to do, we have to find the selling price and we are given with the cost price. and gain or loss percent. It can be gain percent also, loss also. So for finding the selling price, when we are having the gain percent, the formula is 100 plus gain percent divided by 100 into cost price. For finding the selling price when we are having the gain percent, the formula is 100 plus gain percent divided by 100 into cost price. This is the formula for finding the selling price when we are having gain percent. Now for finding the selling price when we are having the loss percent, the formula will be 100 minus loss percent. Just in plus, so in place of plus, we'll put minus. 100 minus loss percent divided by 100 into cost price. Rest of the things are same. Just if we are when we are having gain percent, it will be 100 plus gain percent, and when we are having loss percent, it will be 100 minus loss percent. So remember these formulas, as when we have to find the selling price, when we are given with the gain percent or loss percent, these two formulas will be applied. So friends, there are two more formulas. Just there is some difference in the previous one. Here we have to find the cost price. In earlier we have to find the selling price, but now we have to find the cost price, and we are having the selling price and gain or loss percent. So for finding the cost price, the formula is, for cost price, 100 divided by 100 plus gain percent into SP, that is selling price. Just in the previous one, this 100 plus gain percent was the numerator and this 100 was at the denominator. Just we have reciprocaled them, 100 plus gain percent will be written at the down and divided by 100 will be written on the numerator side, and into selling price, that is given to us. So for finding the cost price when we are having gain percent, the formula is 100 divided by 100 plus gain percent into selling price. Now when we have to find the cost price, we are having the loss percent. So the formula is 100 divided by 100 minus loss percent. Just in plus place of addition, we have put the negative sign, minus sign. So here in the previous one also, this 100 minus loss percent we were having at the numerator. Now it is written at the down. Just the difference is, here it will be plus gain percent and here it will be minus loss percent into selling price. The rest of the things are same. So remember, when we have to find the cost price, these two formulas will be there when we are having gain percent or loss percent. And for finding the selling price, just the difference is, this will be written at the numerator and the 100 will be written at the denominator's place. So remember them and note them down, as they are very important when you have to find the selling price or cost price. So friends, there are some more formulas related to discount also. So when we have to find the selling price, that is the SP, the formula will be marked price, that is MP minus discount. When we are given any discount, that this much discount you will get on this object, then when we have to find the selling price, marked price is that one which is marked on that object. Marked price minus discount, how much discount you are getting. So then you will get the selling price. So now if discount percent, if we are having discount percent, and like we are always getting on any object that this much percent discount you will get, 10% discount, 20% discount. So when discount percent is the rate of discount, when the D percent, that is discount percent, is the rate of the discount, then the formula will be selling price is equal to, when we are finding the selling price and discount percent is the rate of discount, then the formula will be 1 minus D by 100. D by 100, why? Because D percent is there, discount percent is there, that's why the denominator 100 will come, and into MP, that is the marked price. So when we have to calculate the selling price and the discount percent is the rate of discount, then the formula will be 1 minus D by 100 into marked price. So remember these formulas as well because when we have to find the selling price, when we are having discount or marked price. Just note them down and remember them as they are very important in the topic discount text. So friends, next chapter for the formulas is simple interest and compound interest. In this chapter mainly we have three things: principal, rate and the time. Principal is the sum of money at which you are borrowing or lending that sum. So the total amount which you are borrowing or lending, that is known as the principal. Rate is at the which rate percent you are lending that money or borrowing that money. For example, I am borrowing 10,000 at the rate 10% per annum. Means 10% of that principal will be charged on me every year. And time is the how much time for the money you are borrowing or lending. So if rate percent is charged every year, so at which the time, for example, I am borrowing for 2 years, so the rate percent will be charged on both the years. So now amount is the total amount which you are giving to the lender at the end of the time. For example, I have borrowed 10,000 at the rate 10% for 2 years. So after 2 years, the money will be increased. There will be interest on the 10,000, and that total amount will be which I will give to that lender, that will be known as amount. So for finding the simple interest, the abbreviation for simple interest is SI, and for compound interest it is CI. So for finding the simple interest, we are having the formula P into R into T divided by 100. P is the principal, R is the rate, and T is the time. So we'll multiply these three and divide it by 100. Then if we have to find the rate percent, we are not having rate percent and the simple interest we are having. So the formula will be 100 into SI, that is simple interest, divided by principal into time. So this is the formula when we have to find the rate. For finding the principal, we are having the simple interest, we are having rate, time, we have to find the principal. So the formula will be 100 into SI divided by rate into time, that is R into T. So for finding the P, this is the formula. For finding the time, when we have to find the time, the formula will be 100 into SI divided by P into R. We are having principal, we are having rate, we are having simple interest, but we have to find the time. So the formula is 100 into SI divided by principal multiplied by rate. So these are the basic formulas related to simple interest. So friends, we have some more formulas related to compound interest. So when we are having any principal and we have to find the compound interest on that, and that principal is compounded annually, and then if we have to find the amount, then this is the formula. Amount is equal to P, P is the principal, into 1 plus R by 100. R is the rate by 100, because rate is always in percent, that's why at denominator side 100 will come. And this n is the number of years the sum is lended or borrowed. So the time will be on the power side, means it will be written as a exponent. N is the number of years, that is the time. And this R by 100 is the rate. 1 plus R by 100, it will be multiplied by P, that is principal. So this was the formula for calculating the amount. And if we have, if we want to get the compound interest, then it will be amount minus principal. The amount which we will get by this formula, that amount we will subtract from the principal which we are having, and then we will get the compound interest. So this is a very important chapter on full compound interest. Remember it. So friends, our next topic for the formulas is algebra. Algebra is a very wide and important topic We are studying it in 7th class also, 8th and 9th as well. So in this topic mainly we have identities. So these are some main, there are many identities, but these are the most important and the most used identities. So first one is a plus b multiplied by a minus b. A plus b, if it is multiplied by a minus b, then it will be a square minus b square. A square because 2 times a is there, b also 2 times, that's why a square b square, and they will be subtracted. Second identity, a plus b whole square. Two numbers are added and they are having whole square, then it will be a square plus b square plus 2ab. Here a third identity, a minus b whole square. Here it was a plus b whole square, here is a minus b whole square. Just the difference will be in the place of plus 2ab, it will be minus 2ab. Rest of the things will be same, a square plus b square minus 2ab, because here is the sign of minus. Fourth identity is a plus 1 by a whole square. A plus 1 by a whole square will be a square plus 1 by a square plus 2. Next one is a minus 1 a whole square. Here it was a plus 1 by a, and here it is a minus 1 by a. So whole square, it will be a square plus 1 a square minus 2. In place of plus 2, it will be minus 2. Because here is the sign of minus, so in this in the starting of 2 also it will be the sign of minus. So these are the 5 identities. Note them down and remember them. So friends, this was the part 2 of mathematic formulas. Soon I will upload part 3 also. So stay connected with me. That's all for this video. Thank you.